silvering of one side of lens. Silvering of one side of lens. When a lens, in this case we'll take a convex lens. When take it a convex lens, one side that is silver. This is radius 1, this is radius 2. When this is silver, this is equivalent to a lens, convex lens plus one concave mirror. This portion behaves as a convex lens and this portion behaves as a concave mirror. This is convex lens. The entire system of the silvered lens behaves as mirror. That is, for mirror the power is equal to negative of 1 by its focal length, power of mirror. Since the entire system is behaving as a mirror, so the power, effective power, is equal to minus 1 by effective focal length of the system, where FE stands for equivalent focal length of the system, equivalent focal length of the lens, the mirror and the lens. How the refraction takes place? Suppose this is the lens, silvered at this place, at one end. Image from here, suppose this is object is kept here, object, a ray will go from the object like this. After getting refracted, it will go this way, because it deviates from this path after refraction. Then again, this is a mirror surface, it gets reflected again at this point. Since after reflection, this is coming straight, and again it gets refracted. Refracted means it will change from its normal path and it will form the image here. It means the image is formed in the same side of the object. It means this entire system, this is a concave mirror, this is convex mirror, the entire system is a mirror. So now let's find out. It means incident ray will first incident on this lens, gets refracted again at this surface, it will be reflected, and again after reflection it will be refracted in the lens. It means the focal length, it will have two focal length. So this focal length of this one is equal to focal length of lens, this is equal to focal length of the mirror, which is equal to R2, because R2 by 2, which is equal to minus R2 by 2, because R2 is calculated from here to here, the R2 will be here, radius of curvature, the distance from the center up to this place is minus R2 by 2. So since the equivalent power of the system is equal to power of the lens, first it is going to the lens, then it is getting refracted, power of the concave mirror, plus again after reflection it acts to the lens, power of lens. So it is equal to 2 power of lens twice, and the power of the mirror. We know power of the effective system is equal to 1 by effective focal length of the system. Since the system behaves as a mirror, we put the negative sign, because power for a mirror is equal to negative of 1 by focal length of the equivalent focal length. And as it is power of this mirror, this is power of the mirror, this is power of lens. So P is equal to 1 by E. And FE, what is FE? We are calculating FE. FE is equal to radius of curvature of this concave mirror. Concave mirror, radius of curvature will be here. It's equal to radius of curvature of the second surface by 2, which is negative. R2 is negative because R2 will be somewhere here, from here to here. The distance from here to pole, optic center to here is minus R2 by 2, or F is equal to minus RE by 2. Then what is 1 by FL, focus length of lens, refractive index of the lens divided by refractive index of the surrounding medium, which is here, refractive index of the surrounding medium minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is R1, this is R2, R, this is equal to refractive index of glass is mu, this is refractive index of air is 1, mu by 1 is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by R1. R1 for this surface radius of curvature will be measured from here to here along the ray direction, it is plus R1. Plus R1 minus 1 by R2. R2 for this surface will be here. We measure from here to here minus R2. Minus of R2. So is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is 1 by focal length of the lens. Focal length of the mirror. This is focal length of the mirror. This mirror. The effective focal length. Effective focal length, that is effective power, is equal to power of lens plus power of mirror plus power of lens. Power of lens is equal to 1 by, since for power of lens is equal to positive 1 by focal length of the lens, only for mirror. Effective power is, which is acting as a mirror, that's why negative sign we put. And power of mirror is equal to 1 by F of 1 by power of mirror is equal to, which acts as a mirror, so which is a mirror, which is equal to 1 by F of M. So 1 by F of L plus 1 by plus minus 1 by F of mirror plus 1 by focal length of lens. This is, since power of equivalent power is equal to minus 1 by equivalent focal length, since it is behaving as a mirror, the negative sign comes, or we can write 1 by Fe, or we can write power is equal to 1 by FL twice into FL plus FL twice FFL twice of FL minus 1 by FM. Here in this portion we have to put sign convention. If the lens is convex, we'll put plus FL. If the lens is concave, we'll put minus FL. If this is concave mirror, this is concave mirror whose focal length will be here, this is the distance F, which is negative. So we will put FM. If it is concave mirror, he will put minus sign, minus of minus FM. So, and since power effective is equal to minus 1 by FE, which is, it implies FE, equivalent focal length of the system is equal to minus 1 by P. Or you can find out using this formula also. Using this formula, and after this we put here, we have not put sign convention, so we have to put sign convention here to get this Fe. So power of E is equal to minus 1 by Fe, or Fe is equal to minus 1 by Fe. And how we calculate the object distance, image distance. Here to calculate image distance, since the system is behaving as a mirror, we will use mirror equation. 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Since object is kept here, this is the object distance U and this is the image distance V. So, but the focal length of what? Focal length of nor lens, focal length of mirror not to be used. We will use the focal length of the equivalent focal length of the entire system. Equivalent focal length, by which we can calculate 1 by V is equal to 1 by Fe minus 1 by U, and apply sign convention. In general, we can say that when a lens is silvered, then that entire system, silvered with the silver lens, with the silvered surface, behaves as a mirror. So for mirror, power is equal to, for mirror, power is equal to negative of 1 by focal length. Focal length will maybe having positive or negative value depending upon the mirror. But this is generally, it will come minus of 1 by Fm. And since the system is behaving like a mirror, so power of equivalent power of the system is equal to minus of 1 by equivalent focal length. When a plano convex lens silvered at plane surface. So this is plano convex lens, this is plano convex lens and silvered at plane surface. This is radius of curvature of first surface, radius of curvature of second surface. Since radius is counted from here, so the distance is measured from here to here. So we can say plus r. For a plane surface, radius of curvature is equal to infinity. So this is equal to a plano convex lens plus a plane mirror. So it means in this system, when object is kept in front of the lens, so rays from the object will go like this, it gets refracted, deviated from its path, again it gets reflected from the surface, and after reflection from the surface it is again refracted and changes its path. So this is object, this is image. It means the image is also produced at the same side of the object. So it means it behaves first, the entire first it will incident on the lens, refracted, then reflected by this plane mirror, second, and again it comes back and refracted at the lens, and final image is formed. It means the net power of the system is equal to power of lens plus power of mirror plus power of lens. That is, it will have a, since power of lens is equal to positive 1 by focal length. So focal length may be positive or negative for lens. Power of mirror is equal to negative of 1 by focal length of the mirror. Since the entire system, after image is found, behaves as a mirror. So since it is behaves as a mirror, the entire focal length, equivalent focal length, what is equivalent focal length? The power of equivalent power of the system is equal to, since it behaves as a mirror, negative 1 by f of e, or f of e is equal to minus 1 by p of e. So p of e, so power of equivalent power is equal to power of lens is equal to 1 by focal length of lens plus minus 1 by focal length of mirror, focal length of mirror minus 1 by f plus 1 by focal length of lens. So we can see 2 into focal length of lens plus minus 1 by focal length of mirror. We have not applied sign convention in calculation, we have to apply the sign convention. Since this equivalent power, this equivalent lens behaves as a mirror, so we will write P is equal to minus 1 by Fe, or we can simply write Fe is equal to negative of Fe, since P is equal to Fe is equal to Fe is equal to minus 1 by Pe. Calculate Pe and negative of its inverse becomes the effective focal length of this entire system. So what is focal length of the lens? 1 by focal length, by using spherical Miller formula, lens is equal to refractive index of the medium, that is refractive index of the medium, that is glass, by refractive index of the surrounding medium is r, minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Since r1, what is r1? This is r1. R1 is equal to, r1 will be calculated from pole to this. This is r1, this distance. R1 is equal to plus r, we calculated. And r2, r2 is equal to infinity. For the, r2 is equal to infinity for the planar convex lens is equal to mu g is mu by mu I is equal to 1 mu minus 1 into 1 by r. So 1 by focal length is equal to mu minus 1 by r, which is nothing but power of the lens. Now for the mirror, so 1 by focal length of the mirror is equal to 1 by focal length of the mirror, since focal length of the mirror is equal to, this is radius 2 by infinity, which is radius 2 by 2, because focal length is half of the radius of curvature, that is infinity. Radius of curvature infinity by 2 is equal to infinity. So 1 by fm is equal to R2 by 2 is equal to infinity by 2 is equal to infinity. So 1 by fm is equal to power minus 1 by fm is the fm. So pm is equal to, now power of mirror is equal to minus 1 by fm is equal to minus 1 by fm is equal to minus 1 by fm is equal to fm is equal to infinity. Fm is equal to infinity. 1 by fm is equal to minus 1 by infinity is equal to 0, power of mirror. So effective power is equal to power of lens plus power of mirror plus power of lens. Power of lens is equal to mu minus 1 by r. This is 2 into mu minus 1 by r plus 0. Power of mirror is equal to 0. So 1 by Fe minus 1 by Fe is equal to 2 into mu minus 1 by r. R, focal length of this effective system, focal length effective minus r by 2 into refractive index minus 1. And VUFE, use mirror formula to calculate the object distance. So 1 by V plus 1 by U, mirror formula, 1 by F effective, because V is found due to this combined effective focal length of the system. So 1 by V is equal to 1 by Fe minus 1 by U. So now here, this is a general formula on which we have to put the sign convention for Fe and U. Since Fe comes out to be negative, this behaves as a concave mirror. Plano convex lens silvered at spherical surface. It means this is planar convex lens. This is plane convex lens silvered at spherical confines. It means it what? This is equal to a lens with a concave mirror. So when object is kept here, it will go there and refracted here, then reflected here, then again refracted here, image will be formed. It means it undergoes reflection, it incident on this lens, plano convex lens, and get refracted, then it gets reflected, then again gets refracted and forms the image here. So total power of the system is equal to power of the lens plus power of the mirror plus power of the lens. So total power is equal to 2 into power of lens plus power of mirror. Power of lens what? This surface, this is silvered, this is R1, which is equal to infinity, because for a plane surface radius of curvature is located at infinity. This is R2, so its radius of curvature will be located here. From here, if you measure this way, it is equal to, we can call it as R, which is negative of R. So we can say power of lens is equal to refractive, this is glass, this is air. So refractive index of glass divided by refractive index of air is nothing but 1. Refractive index of glass by refractive index of air minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Refractive index of glass we call is mu. Refractive index of air is 1 into 1 by R1. 1 by R1. So 1 by, this is infinity, 1 by R1 is equal to 1 by infinity is equal to 0. 0 minus 1 by R2, R2 is equal to minus R. So power of lens is equal to, this get cancelled, mu minus 1 by R. This is power of lens. And power of mirror. Power of mirror. So since the power of mirror is equal to nothing but a radius of curvature, because this silver surface R2 and this forms as the concave mirror, this surface R2 by 2. And R2, what is R2? R2 is equal to minus R by 2. So this is focal length of mirror. Focal length of mirror is equal to this much. And power of mirror is equal to reverse of it. It's power of minus 1 by Fm. It's equal to minus 1 by minus R by 2, which is equal to 2 by R. So net power is equal to 2 into power of lens, 2 into power of lens, 2 into power of lens plus power of mirror. So 2 into power of lens is mu minus 1 by R plus power of mirror is equal to 2 by R, and adding this will be 2 mu by R minus 2 by R plus 2 by R. This get cancels. So power of the effective system is equal to 2 into mu by R. 2 into mu by R. And this side is silver. So we can say power, because this entire combination, this is also concave mirror, this entire system also behaves like a mirror. We do not know what type of mirror. If it is negative sign is coming for this power, it is concave. P is equal to minus 1 by, since for P effective is equal to F of effective, or F of effective is equal to minus 1 by P, is equal to minus 1 by P. 1 by P means minus will come reverse of it, minus R by 2 into mu. 1 by P is equal to, it means 1 by P is equal to R by 2 mu, minus R by 2. So effective focal length of this combination is negative, so which is a negative quantity. Therefore this combination behave as concave mirror. So far we have calculated. Now to calculate the image distance, so u is equal to object distance, v is equal to image distance, and what is focal length? Focal length of the system is effective focal length of the silvered concave lens is equal to effective focal length of the silvered lens, that is effective focal lens. Here we will use mirror formula, because it behaves, the entire system behaves as a mirror. We will use mirror formula. What is mirror formula? 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F effective, or 1 by V is equal to 1 by Fe minus 1 by U. And knowing this distance Fe, where Fe stands for this value, Fe stands for this value, for the convex lens, plane of convex lens is centered at a curved surface.